ओके, दिस इज हैपनिंग। सो हियर यू कैन सी द चॉम्स्की हायरार्की ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस, एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो मेंशन्ड इन द ब्रैकेट दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज इज एक्सेप्टेड बाय व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ऑटोमेशन। So you can see here, finite automata is here. Finite automata is here. So what languages are acceptable by finite automata? You regular languages, right? So we are speaking about regular languages only in this course. We're less concerned about other three types of languages. Like context-free language and context-sensitive language, recursively enumerable language. So we are not going to discuss all these things. Okay. So our main target is knowing the regular language properly, because most of the programming languages they mainly for the recognizer, the lexical analyzer part, they follows the regular languages. Okay. They use the regular languages. But yeah, somewhat the context-free languages, we will find the use of context-free language also. We will find in the next chapter, which is called syntax analysis. Okay. So, when I speak about finite automation, so there is two kind of classification. One is finite automation with output and finite automation with input. That means first kind of automation, which takes input but it also gives output on every transition. Say it is going from Q0 to Q1, taking an input, say A, it also gives some output, say 1. Okay. But there is another kind of automation where for doing this transition from Q0 to Q1, it needs some input A, but it does not give you any output on the transition or at the time of transition or after reaching to this state. Okay, so this is what happens. So based on the output it gives, based on that you may have two kind of automations. One is called Mealy machine, another is called Moore machine. Now again, in this subject, this Mealy machine and Moore machine we are not going to discuss. Okay, based on input, you can classify it into two types. One is called non-deterministic finite automata. Non-deterministic finite automata and deterministic finite automata. Okay, so NFA and DFA. So these two things are what we are going to discuss in this course, and we are going to use. So you know that what are these things? NFA or DFA or finite automata in general, if you say. So only thing it does is that it takes a sequence of input symbols, and if it reach to some final state, it tells you that it is accepted, or if your transition ends at any non-final state, then it will tell you that what input sequence you have given that is not accepted. Okay, so the only result you can get is accepted and not accepted. So how it looks like, it is something looks like this. You have automation here. You give some input, like say you have given int, so whether it is accepted or not accepted. Now, if you are using something, say this automation is implemented for say C language. Okay, so in that case, this sequence of characters int will be accepted, okay, or it will be recognized, or if it is not, then it will not going to be accepted, or it is not going to be recognized. Okay, so output here is going to be either accept or not accept. Okay, so this kind of things where you usually notice that elevators, vending machines, lexical analyzer. So we are at lexical analyzer. This is where the application of finite automata we are going to see, and it does not have any kind of memory, not even temporary memory. It does not have it. Okay, it does not have any memory. Now, in more generalized way, we can show it like this. We gave input string here. The string can be think about think like this, that you have a input tape where you give the input string, say you have int. Okay, then it will this will read one character, per per time or at a time. Okay, and it will answer you that whether it is accept or reject. That is the output. We formally define the finite automata in five tuples: Q, epsilon, delta, Q0, F. Okay, so sorry. So what is Q? Q is finite set of states, capital Q. Then we have the epsilon, okay, sorry, capital sigma. Okay, so what is this? This is again finite set of input symbols. Okay, then what you have? You have delta. So what is delta? It is transition function. And then you have Q0. So Q0 is a special state. We call it as start state. And definitely Q0 is a member of capital Q. And another thing we have, that is capital F. It is again finite set of final states. And definitely F is a subset of capital Q. Okay, so here you must remember to write these words finite set. Okay, it is necessary to mention. Okay, don't ignore that. Why should we write finite set every time? No, you have to write. Okay, because mathematically that is correct. Okay, now if you see a transition diagram or graph which accept a string ABBA. Okay, simply one string it is going to accept, anything else it is going to reject. Okay, so here you can see Q0, we have, we already know Q0 is the start state. Okay, then it first reads A as input, it goes to Q1, then after coming to Q1, it reads the next input, it is B, so it again makes a transition to Q2, then it reads the next character, another B. Okay, so again it is having a path from Q2 for B, which is going to Q3, and after coming to Q3, it is reading the next character, which is A, and for A, Q3 is leading you to Q4. Okay, and Q4 is a final state already. Okay, so this is the automation which takes A, B, B, A, and it leads you from the start state to the final state. Okay, now if you give something else, say if you give BB only, then what will happen? See, again it will start from the start state, it will read the first symbol for B from Q0, there is a path, right? Q0 to Q5, so it will bring you to Q5. Okay, and for another B, okay, after coming to Q5, it will read this B. Okay, if there is a self loop. Okay, and whatever is there, A, B, A, B, whatever sequence, it is going to, the self loop is going to consume all of them, and it is going to stay on Q5 itself. Okay, so that is the reason sometimes you call this kind of state cells trap, okay, or a reject state. All right, so here is the automation. You can see first it reads A Q0, so it's come to current state become, so A is already in a readout, so current state become Q1. So at Q1 it will read out B and it will lead to Q3. And at Q3, highlighted because this is your current state. At Q3, Q2 is current state, so it will read out this B, and it will lead you to Q3. Then, at your current state is Q3, and right now you will read out this A, and it will lead you to Q4, which is in a highlighted. So when your string is end, you're standing where? You're standing at a final state. So you will say that okay, ABBA is accepted by this transition graph. Okay. Now, can you try lambda on this transition diagram? What will happen if you give lambda as input? You just write in the chat box. What will happen if you give lambda as input? No answer. Okay, what will happen if you give A, B, A as input? So this is your transition diagram and you are giving input A, B, A. Your input is A, B, A. Then what will happen? No answer. Risk Q5. Somebody said risk Q5. It will risk Q5. ends in Q5. Correct. It will end in Q5. Okay. Now, if I ask you, draw a transition diagram which will accept A, B, A. Can you do that? You can see, you can answer like this. For the current one, I'm writing how to write this answer in the chat box. So, say 0th state, I give A, then it takes me to 1, then I give B, it takes me to Q2, at Q2, I give B, which takes me to Q3. At Q3, we give A, which takes me to final state 4. So I am writing 4F. Okay, so this can be the answer for the previous one. A, B, B, A. Okay, sorry, I have missed A. Okay, let me rewrite it here. Okay. So this can be the answer for the current one. So what will be the DFA or transition diagram for ABA? Can you answer in the chat box? Did you understand how I want the answer in the chat box? Okay, at zero, Haryam is answering. At zero, if you give A, it is taking you to 1. Then one to at 1, if you give B, it is taking you to 2. And then at 2, again it is iterating there. Haryam's answer is wrong. Yes, Pandey, your answer is correct. Why you are going to 5A? See, first thing you understand, you have to design a new DFA, okay? New transition diagram, not DFA, transition diagram, I will say, because you are writing here in the chat box. Yeah, for Rishab, it is correct. You can write 3F so that we can understand this is the final state. Okay, I have a phone call. Give me 1 minute. Hello. Hello. Phone. Oh. All right. So I got answer from Rishabh. Okay, so let me draw the diagram here for you. We'll have Q0 as initial state. At Q0, if you give A, it should take you to Q1. Then at Q1, if you give B, it will take you to Q2. And at Q2, if you give A, it will take you to Q3, and definitely Q3 is the final state. Okay, if you give anything else, for make it complete, you make Q4 as a reject or trap state. So at Q0, you have a path for A. So we are assuming that our alphabet set is only A and B, two alphabets are there. Okay, for A, we have a path, so we put B here. Okay, from Q1, for B, we have a path already. So for A, we create this path. From Q2, for A, we have a path. So for for B, we create this path. And from Q3, whatever, there is no path, okay, for either for A or B. So for A or B, whatever you go, you just redirect it to Q4, and Q4 will become the trap state. All right. And if I ask you to draw a transition diagram for lambda, then how will it look like? It will be something like only one state. Q1, this is the final state, and this is the final state, and this is the initial state. Okay? Because without giving anything, you are